Let's see the graph related to ideal solutions. Here, at this end, only component A is present. At this end, only B is present. We are taking this A and B in different proportions. Initially, 1 plus 0. After, in the second sample, 0.9, 0.1. In the third sample, 0.8, 0.2. In the fourth sample, 0.7, 0.2. In that way, if you continue it at the other end, it will be only B. Okay, so here only 2A, that side only pure B. So here pressure is due to only component B. Here pressure is due to only component B. So pure component means E0A, this side, E0B, that side. Okay, so when the composition of XA, when the composition of A, the mixture decreases, what happens? Pressure due to A also decreases. It will form a straight line like this. Similarly, from left to right, there is an increase in the composition of B. That's why its pressure increases. So, first line is of PA. This is PA. PA means partial pressure of A. This is PB, partial pressure of B. PA, AB. See the trend in A and B. There is increase in the concentration of A from left to right. That's why pressure due to A is decreasing. Similarly, from left to right, what is happening? Composition, that means the mole fraction of B is increasing. So there is increase in the pressure of B. At any point, how to calculate total pressure? So, this dotted line indicates the total pressure of the mixture. That means P total it is. P total means PA plus PB. PA plus PB. That means at any point in the composition, say some point Z here. This is the point Z. At this point Z, let this value be some PX. This value be some Vz. Okay. So at the point Z, what is total pressure P? Total pressure P means PA plus PB. At Z, this is PB. This value is P from 0 to PZ. This value, this total value is what? This is total pressure. How to get this PZ? Here PZ is equal to, it is Px, let it be some Py. So Pz is equal to Px plus Py. That means at any point in the curve, we can sum up the partial pressures of A and B to get the total pressure. Similarly, so this is the ideal behavior line, ideal solution line. This is PA. Similarly, this is PB. Already I wrote here. So this is the line of component A, partial pressure line of. This is the partial pressure line of component B. So decreasing trend, increasing trend. Okay, right. See here what is happening in total pressure, how to get total pressure. At any point, that means at any composition, total pressure is equal to sum of partial pressure of A and B. Okay, right. So total pressure, how does it vary in the composition of A and B? Check it once. Here, which is more volatile between A and B, which is more volatile? B. So when there is increase in the concentration of B in the liquid mixture, total pressure increases. See, there is a upward trend. Why there is upward trend? Because B is more volatile. So when you increase the concentration of B in the mixture, then total pressure increases. What happens when A is increasing? So further see, A is a less volatile compound. That's why in the mixture, if you go from right to left, what happens? There from left, right to left, A is increasing. B being a being less volatile, total pressure decreases. This is the trend. So when you move from right to left, there is decrease in the total pressure. Right to left means there is increase in the concentration of A. So in a liquid mixture, when increase the concentration of more volatile component, that means B, total pressure increases. In the same way, when increase the concentration of less volatile component, that means A, total pressure decreases. So in that way, total pressure of the liquid mixture depends on the composition of A and B. Okay, so this is the graph related to ideal solutions. Stop here.